Welcome once again. I know this material here is getting very, what you might say, advanced, very deep, very amazing. So I understand it may be difficult. And I'm taping a lot now because I was all out push for December 21st to get to a certain level of clarity by that date. So we're going to continue here. And this is the most advanced yet. This video will be the most advanced clarity yet. Let's say you go to a doctor and the doctor says, you have a tumor or something and we got to take it out. And you say, well, let me go get a second opinion. Okay, second opinions. Let me go get a second opinion. All right. Now, what is existence? I can tell you what it is. In a sophisticated way, you can say it's like a three-dimensional movie in where we seem to be starring in it, but we're also watching the movie. We're also watching it. But to make it simpler, we will say that whim, called the ego, Satan, Antichrist, adversary, you know, whatever, it's really whim, is interpreting reality, has an opinion, is interpreting reality in a certain way, and it is telling us its interpretation of reality. And this whole thing of bodies, of people, of worlds, of thoughts, emotions, all this stuff, it is all 100% the ego's interpretation of reality that it's telling us, like in a movie. And we're watching this movie. We're seeing this body move around and do stuff, and we think we are the body. No, the body is just a prop, an actor or actress that the ego is projecting for us, so in a three-dimensional way. And so we, spirit, awareness, is watching this, is aware of it, and saying, huh, that's a really, that's what I am, huh? And because the ego's saying, this is reality. When the ego says, this is reality, meaning you are a body, you get sick, you age, you die, you're among other bodies, you're among other things that get, that age, that fall into dust, dust to dust to dust to dust to dust. That is what you are. That is the ego's interpretation of reality for us. And so we're very, very, very much used to watching this. And so we assume, well, maybe this is what I am. But I'll tell you this, we deserve a second opinion. All right? And that's called standing up to whim, which is the most difficult thing to do in this world. Any place. It is the most difficult thing to do, period, is to stand up to that bully whim and say, no, I'm getting a second opinion about reality. Fortunately, we have Dr. Holy Spirit, who will give us a second opinion. We say, Holy Spirit, whim has this opinion about reality, and it's giving me its interpretation of what reality is. And I'd like to ask you if you have a different interpretation of reality. And would you like to present that to me? Because I'd like to get a second opinion. Because I don't think this whim is telling me the truth. And the Holy Spirit, we are told, is that's what it does. It's ready for your willingness to present its interpretation of reality. That is what Jesus says in the Course in Miracles. And I believe what Jesus says. My reason tells me he's accurate. Now, I haven't personally experienced the Holy Spirit's new interpretation, but from the standpoint of reasoning, I get it. I get it. I get what Jesus is saying. So maybe I will get that interpretation from the Holy Spirit. So the basic dynamic of here is, let's get a second opinion. We're used to the ego telling us this is reality. And we say, you know what, ego? Let me get a second opinion on this. Now, the ego doesn't like that. In fact, it's furious at that. It's like a doctor who says, how dare you seek in a second opinion? I'm the expert. Nobody's a better expert. How dare you insult me with seeking a second opinion? So very few have ever stood up to the bully and the bluff of whim. Very few. They always seek the deal. The ego screams and rants and says, you know what, I'm going to exterminate you, but you know what, I'm such a nice, so wonderful, and God-like, I'm going to offer you a deal. And then you grab a hold of the deal. And you say, whew, wow, I avoided that one. Wow, that's scary. So standing up to whim and saying, I'm getting a second opinion, is what the spiritual path is all about. It's, and how one gets to the point where they're able to do that is unique in each case. There's no academic textbook that tells you exactly this is how you're going to do it. No, no such thing. There can just be encouragement. And some techniques, some this, some that, you know, practice this, practice that, but still, it's still going to be unique. So, second opinion from the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is supposedly presents to us its interpretation of reality. It has an interpretation, it has a take on reality. But it was created specifically to give us an interpretation of reality that doesn't attack whim's interpretation of reality. It doesn't attack it. But rather, like I said, it extends beyond it. It shows an extension beyond it. So, this in a nutshell is the entire spiritual path. Hey, Holy Spirit, what's your interpretation of reality? That simple. Boil it all down to just one statement. Holy Spirit, what's your interpretation of reality? I ask to be shown so that I may know. What's your interpretation? Let me view your interpretation. I'm used to viewing the ego's interpretation. Let me view your interpretation. Let me see if I can determine which one is actually more accurate. So that's the sum total of the whole spiritual path boiled down into one statement. Holy Spirit, I'd like, please present to me your interpretation of reality. And I'm not saying tell me who I am, because we need to broaden it out. Because reality, who says that there's an I in reality? See, that's putting conditions on it already, right? Tell me who I am. Wait a minute, maybe let the Holy Spirit present the totality of reality. What is reality? What is reality? We want to know, what is reality? That's the question. Because the ego's showing us the totals package. See, this is reality. This is reality. This energy, this chemistry, biochemistry, this gradual erosion and building up an erosion of all matter, the spinning of the movement, celestial movements of all the planets and the stars and the galaxies, the space, the heat and the cold, and the physics, all this stuff. So this is reality. And most of all, the perception of it through the senses, saying this is how you perceive reality. This is reality. This is how you perceive it. You're immersed in it. You're perceiving it. You're feeling it. You're tasting it. This is what's real. That's the ego telling us this. And we're saying, hey, you know what, ego? I got some doubts about this. It's various things just don't add up. It doesn't add up so well. And what about all the suffering? What about all the misery? So much stuff's going on. I'm not going to even talk about it. But it's always that way here in the world. Always people dying, all these sicknesses coming up, all these loss of this, loss of that, and scraping and trying and falling and getting sick and trying to bounce back and all this terrible. This is the ego's version of reality. It's its version. That's its interpretation. So we deserve a second opinion. We deserve a second opinion. Just ask for a second opinion. That's it. Now, again, very few have done that, and even fewer have actually been willing to view the second opinion of the Holy Spirit. Very, very few. Because the ego is such a tyrant. You know, it threatens us with annihilation. It says, you do that, I'm never going to help you ever again. Interesting. Yeah. I'm never going to show you reality again, the ego will say. I'm never going to present it to you. You won't have anything. So, yeah, it's like a tyrannical doctor saying, if you go to get a second opinion, I'm not going to operate on you. Forget it. You can't even come in the door again, you know? Something like that. And say, oh no, please doc, no, don't do that. So it takes a lot of nerve to do this, so I'm trying to do it. But I am convinced that this is the heart and soul of the whole thing. Just Holy Spirit, present your interpretation of reality to me. That's it. That's it. The sum total. Boil it all down. Show me so that I may know. Show me so that I may know. Show me so that I may know. So, there it is. There it is. Very simple. Just let it, you know, reverberate. Let it reverberate. Let it reverberate. And don't be discouraged if it doesn't happen. It hasn't happened for me yet, and I've been working at it my whole life. But it doesn't mean I'm giving up or saying it's wrong. No, it's. I believe it is. It is right. I believe Jesus and what he says. just because all the techniques and practice hasn't worked yet, you know, doesn't mean that the Holy Spirit doesn't have this interpretation to present to us. It's just for some reason we are still trying to cut a deal with the ego. And I've noticed that the ego, I'm getting closer to feeling the Holy Spirit's, what the Holy Spirit has to offer, and the ego's desperately trying to offer me deals, all sorts of, hey, I'll send you to Hawaii, you know, or I'll send you into a beautiful resort, or I'll give you all these great graphics, I'll do this, I'll make you really look great, I'll do, and it's like, it's desperately throwing out all these carrots, you know, to me, saying, hey, don't worry, I'm going to come through for you, you know. I say, well, look, you never have come through me before, and that's your version of reality, is faithlessness, promises that aren't kept. So let me view the Holy Spirit's interpretation of reality. Let's see how that goes. So the ego's not happy with me right now, that is for sure. Very unhappy. And again, it's all constantly offering these wonderful escapes, that you're going to be really happy. Let me get you a new camera. Let me get you this. It never gets me anything. The only promises to get it, then I end up getting it and paying the price for it, etc., etc. And everything comes very difficult and super stressful, and it is very horribly difficult. And you know, the ego says, "Well, you're just not doing it right," or something. It's always got an excuse. It's always, but that's its version of reality, right? Things don't work smoothly. There's problems. There's blame. It doesn't satisfy. And all this struggle. That's its version of reality, which it is presenting. Presenting all these actors on a stage are the ego's presentation. It's play. So Holy Spirit, show me your interpretation of reality and the play that you have for us, not just me, but for everyone. And more specifically, you can say, well, what am I going to do? Show me my role. Show me how I interact. Show me what is your interpretation of my functioning in reality, whatever I happen to be in your. You know, interpretation. Sure, but better just say, Holy Spirit, show me your interpretation of reality. Because that covers everything. In one statement, it covers everything. Forget about all the details. If you showed the whole picture, then, you know, it's all in there. It's all in there. You can see it all. If you're shown just little details, you're not sure about what the whole picture is. So just show me the whole picture. And let's take a look at it. Together, we'll take a look at it. Maybe we'll invite Jesus in. Jesus, why don't you sit in on this, and we'll take a look at this presentation together. Something like that. Or invite anyone in you want to, who's already seen the presentation and accepted, etc. And say, why don't you, let's do the screening together here, and we'll take a look at it. See what it is. So, if you get to the point where you're that adventurous and you're willing to say, you know what, I'm going to take a look at it. I'm going to take a look. Let's take a look. That's the goal. That's the goal. Just take a look. Take a look. Take a look. Get a second opinion. And then you get that second opinion and you say, hey, wow, I like this one. You know, this reminds me of something. Reminds me. It rings true. So evidently that's what takes place, and that's what we're aiming for. So keep aiming for it. The 21st is just coming up real soon, and I think it's a time of decision. It's a time of decision that we're coming up, whether we're going to continue on with the ego's interpretation of reality, or we're going to go toward the Holy Spirit's interpretation of reality. That's the decision that needs to be made by the 21st of December, I believe, 2013. Probably that's the splitting of the destiny paths. All right, one path will continue on viewing the Holy Spirit, viewing the ego's interpretation of reality. Okay. okay, it's opinion of reality, it's interpretation. We'll continue on with that, thinking that this is it. The other will go off with the Holy Spirit's interpretation and opinion of reality, okay? Easy to understand the parting of the destiny paths that way. Easy to understand, easy to see, quote unquote, 4D and 5D, which is simply sort of different paths, walking along as you walk along, getting used to different interpretation, the ego and the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, the ego say, why don't you mix the two? And the Holy Spirit says, no, I won't do that, I won't do that, I won't do that. Why? Supreme confusion will reign in your mind if that were to take place. The Holy Spirit will not mix the two. The ego, of course, it will say anything. So it'll say, on a whim, it says, yeah, let's mix the two. Look how cruel it is to you. How cruel. It's basically it's saying to you, why not suffer, you know, just insane confusion that'll just devastate your mind. You know, why not do that? You know, that just shows how irresponsible the ego is, how mad it is, really, how whimsical it is. Holy Spirit says, no, we're not mixing the two. We're not mixing the two. When you see the one, you're going to go along that path, you know, and I'm going to show it. I'm going to be true to it. I'm not going to mix the ego's, you know, interpretation of reality in with it. No way. No way. It's like you're pouring white dye, white paint. You say, I want to paint the room white. And someone else says, no, I want to paint the room black. And then, the ego says, hey, let's mix the black and the white and everybody will be happy. What do you get? This muddy gray. So, you know, you who wanted the room painted white, you're not happy at all with the muddy gray, are you? Not at all. And the ego's saying, well, good, at least they didn't hear the Holy Spirit's interpretation, because the ego knows that once you see the Holy Spirit's interpretation of reality, the ego's finished, its interpretation is finished, because you realize just how absolutely wretched, total lie, deceit, and has nothing to do with reality, total... It has nothing to do with reality whatsoever. Completely bogus. And it knows that. So it says, hey, let's mix white and black and get gray. Just to keep us from painting our room white, as it were. Okay? So again, Holy Spirit, show me your interpretation of reality. Just keep it the simplest prayer possible. That's your path. If you want to go on to, quote unquote, the fifth dimension, the path we call the fifth dimension, which takes us into a familiarity with the Holy Spirit's interpretation of reality, including the death-free realm, paradise realm, you know, beautiful realms where everything is sparklingly fresh, continuously, there's no death of anything like that. If you want to go along that path of familiarity, then you say, Holy Spirit, please present to me your interpretation of reality. Okay, I want it, I choose it, and also let it be, so be it, okay? It's really that simple. So hopefully you can kind of practice this and think about it and keep your good habits going through December 21st, okay? That's what I'm trying to do. So far, so good, and we'll just keep at it. All right, very great, that's it for this one.